The world of paint correction and polishing is getting more complicated by the minute. And every week, we receive hundreds of questions in comments on social media, on videos, and emails. We want to answer those questions. This is Rufus Replies.
So as a trainer, one of the most frequent conversations that we often get with users of our polishers is the desire to change backing plates on the two different versions of our Bigfoot polishers. So a lot of folks have actually tried this. You might have tried this, but we do get this question on email, social media, and in our classroom. Is they will buy our Bigfoot 21 millimeter tool. They will take this 150 millimeter backing plate off, and they will swap it with the backing plate that's on our Bigfoot 15 millimeter tool, which is 125 millimeter diameter, and they will put this backing plate on that tool. And the assumption is that this is going to give them additional performance. Now, what I want to point out here is that by making that change, it's not a small slight adjustment. It's actually a pretty dramatic impact on the tool and its components. To illustrate this, let's talk about this cutout tool here. You can see the internal components in the polisher. Now, this counterweight assembly, which is similar to all dual action polishers, however, ours is engineered with some very, very precise tolerances. So how this movement works is there is a backing plate and a pad that is orbiting on one side of the orbit. Inside the tool there is an equal mass and weight balancing the tool. So the movement of the tool is doing a movement like this. So any slight variation in that balance can actually add to stresses on bearings and internal components. So let's talk about the numbers. Here is our Bigfoot 21 millimeter tool, has our 150 millimeter backing plate going to our 180 millimeter diameter pads that match up with this. If you calculate that surface area on that pad diameter, it equates to about a 254 square centimeter surface area of the pad on this tool. By contrast, this is our 15 millimeter Bigfoot tool with a 125 millimeter backing plate going to a 150 millimeter pad. To calculate the square surface area on this, we're talking about 176 square centimeters, which is about 10.7 square inches. So those numbers, if you do the relative comparison on surface area, it amounts to 36% difference in surface area when you take this backing plate and pad and put it on this tool. So that is not a little adjustment, it's actually pretty significant. Now let's go to pad diameter itself. Between the 150 millimeter pad diameter here and the 180 millimeter pad diameter here, we are talking about an 18% difference and pad diameter. So remember, when you make the switch, it's not a little switch, it's a significant one. And probably the most significant impact by making this change in backing plate diameter is the mass and the weight. So the mass of this backing plate combined with the average mass of the pad on this tool is about 33 grams. But if we take the backing plate and the pad weight that is match to this tool, it's about 20 grams. That is a 49% difference in weight that you're throwing on that tool. So again, this is not a little change. It ends up being a big impact. And what we're concerned about here is vibration and stress to the internal components and the long-term durability of the tool functioning. So we know when you purchase any of our Bigfoot polishers that that tool belongs to you, and there's a strong interest in many people to modify tools. We just want you to experience our peak performance built into the engineering of our tools, and we want you to have a long-lasting, high-performing tool. And our best recommendation is that you don't do any modifications. You use the tool as it was engineered. So if this video is helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe. Please enter your question and comments. And in a future version of Rupus Replies, we may actually pick yours.